Guys, welcome to Imran's Adventures. I'm here at the Lake Superior Provincial Park, and we're gonna hike the coastal trail for about 5 days. And this is the starting point at Gargantua Harbor. Beautiful.
Where we just started, we parked our car over there, and just came over little bridge to this harbor. Beautiful pebble beach. First part is through the forest. That's Gargantua Harbor. About half an hour of the forest walk. This is the first uphill section. It's going over these rocks. Keeps climbing up and up. About an hour of hiking through thick forest. Climbing a lot of hills. We have arrived at this first viewpoint. Blue sky in the background. Tiny islands. Bird flying, nice breeze, no mosquitoes, beautiful all around. After a lot of forest walk, coming up to this viewpoint. This is the trail, believe it or not. See that marker over there? And I'm standing right here. And I have no idea how I would go there. So you have to come down around and over these rocks. I can't imagine doing this if it was raining. That would be really dangerous. And then I had to climb all over here. Oh my god. This keeps going, more stuff like that. Looks easy in video. This apparently is the trail. See this cairn? One cairn over there. And I think you can't really see in the camera how unreal this is. And then I have to go across that gap. So you see the next marker is over there by that tree. Man, oh man, this is something else. Then you have to go through there, climb all the way up. What a trail. That's the other hiker group behind me. behind us. How did they even think of making this a trail? Go straight up. So, see, there's a marker over there on the other side. How am I supposed to go there? This is something else. Even when you're not by the shore, scrambling on rocks, even in the forest, you have to go through stuff like that. And up. Where's the next marker? I see on the other side of this big rock. So we have to go up, I think, then keep going up. To climb all those rocks and all those rocks and many, many more rocks before that. If you love rocks, this is the place to be. Came out of these rocks and then look. Way over there in those trees is the next marker. So somehow we're supposed to go down across that boulder field and go into the forest. And rinse and repeat. Wow. This seems like some old riverbed or something. I saw similar ones in Pakasa. These are fun to walk on. So I saw a lookout sign over here. Thank you.
This water comes through this channel. And this is a swimming pool.
Wow.
That's pretty awesome. Many hours of grueling hike coming back to beach. I hope this is the campsite, although I'm not sure. Don't think this is the campsite. Oh man. Okay, I see someone calling me over there. So this is our campsite for tonight. It's day one. We did about 12 kilometers. So dinner is done, tent is set up, everything is done. So we're just gonna relax on the beach for a couple of hours, then go to bed. Nice sandy beach. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. Can't really see the sunset today from here. It looks like it must be really amazing. Okay, day two, just packed up and ready to go. It's about 12 o'clock, we slept in. That's my backpack ready to go, Naman bhai. So today we have to do about 12.5 kilometers to Orphan Day campsite. Okay,
Let's go. Campsite 10-15 minutes ago, and this is what we're going on right now. Beautiful solid ground to walk on. What a nice day. Beautiful, sunny, not hot, no bugs. Nice breeze. Amazing. Beautiful.
Amazing, guys.
Just walking over these beautiful rocks, perfectly rounded, all shapes, but they are very unstable, so you have to be really careful where you step. Came upon these perfectly shaped egg shape round rocks. So pretty. I don't know how they ended up here. That's where we came from, behind those trees. So far today's been really neat. No forest walk, all along the lake. And there is the moon. Let's see. Beautiful. We came from here, found this beautiful pool. How did the water end up here? Maybe rain? This is just, let's go up. It's the other side, and let's go up. Wow, that's a beautiful pool. Nice. Amazing. Walking over these jumbled rocks. Kind of have to pick your way through. These would be really slippery if it was raining. So luckily it's a dry day. Go through those rocks.
see a marker on the other side.
Wow, this is crazy. Jumbo rocks. That's what we came through. Look at the size of the middle rock. Crazy. Rock hopping. All day rock hopping. Oh my god. Cross this all the way to the boys. Rock. So easy to walk on this if it's dry, which it is today. Kind of steep. Nice. Coming up to this beautiful cobble beach. Not sure if there's a campsite here. I'm glad I didn't have to climb that cliff over there. It's a hot day. Hot, hot, hot. Thank you. was raining. I don't know how would anyone go over these. That's where I was with Abdullah sitting right there. It's quite a climb. Then go down and up again. Wow, this is tough. Nightmarish climb and steep descent. Coming up to this boulder beach. I think I found an egg. That could be dinner for tonight. Oh no, it's a rock. After about an hour walking through thick brush, looks like we're coming up to a nice cobble beach. Nice, I think the boys are up there. Beautiful.
That's pretty neat. The water is going in here. I think we had arrived at BT Cove. That's where we're gonna stay tonight. Nice beach walk. Okay, end of day two. Dinner is done. Camp is set up. Boys are fishing. That's where I'm sleeping tonight. Yesterday was really, really hot, so I didn't set up the tarp today. Might get really cold, but we'll see. Another beautiful evening. See you tomorrow. It's about 10:30 and we're leaving BT Cove campsite. And our target today is Robertson Cove, which is about 13 kilometers from here. Ready, guys? Okay. Okay, see you on the trail. So after leaving BT Cove, we walked through the forest for about half an hour. Came out through this opening. Cloudy day, but in a way it's good. Yesterday was really, really hot. Go over these rocks and I think it's going in to the forest again. Just came through the bush and again, same idea. Let's go over these rocks. A nice cobble beach over here. Coming on this beautiful beach. Nice sand. Oh, that's a lovely campsite. Should have stayed here last night. Into the forest he goes. Overcast day. It's nice.
I say every 1 hour we take a stop.
Yep. Nice cobble beach over there. Just taking a break here in the cobble beach with all of that to do. Looks like some clouds are rolling in. Might get some rain. Beautiful. So after the forest section, this is the going back down to the lake. I don't see a way. Okay, I just have to go down here. It's
sky is clearing, looks like, which is nice. That's where we came from. So today it's been constant on and off, both section followed by a coast section followed by a bush section. Just keep going. I like this overcast day, no sun. It's much easier to hike. Yesterday was brutal. This stretches so on and on. And yes. After another bush section, came upon this ledge. There's a beautiful cobble beach down there. And let's start over here. This is not for the faint of the heart. This is the cobble beach I was looking at from the top. Beautiful day, nice breeze, some blue sky, perfect for hiking. Arrived at Orphan Lake campsite. I see two people kayaking over there. I think that's the Bald Hill or something like that, that we have to climb up. I think that's the biggest climb of today. Beautiful flowers. We're leaving the beach behind now and heading up this way, and I think now the climb to the Bald Head starts. Quite exposed section. Just went over the Bald Head Hill. Now walking through this beautiful forest. Bird sounds. Nice smell of the forest, fresh air. Amazing. I don't know what bird that is. It's like a parrot. I've never seen this before. I just moved it. There they are. Hello. This is the trail. That's what you have to walk on all day. The max we have many days, like 1 to 2 kilometers per hour. But that speed, we need like a week. So, I don't know. On these big rocks, very unstable rocks. You have to go in here actually. Seems like walking on the beach would be easier. It's as hard as walking on those loose rocks. That's where we can go, around the corner. End of day 3, we are at Robertson Cove. Okay, morning of day 4, we are all packed up, ready to roll. All set?
Yep. Not all set.
It's a bit foggy this morning, but the sun is coming out and I think it's gonna burn the fog away. Beautiful day. Okay, see you on the trail. So far we've been walking on these very, very slippery, unstable rocks. Still a lot of fog in the background. It's very humid too. I'm already sweating. Going over huge boulders. Everything is covered by fog. after a couple of hours of walking through the forest and on the rock shore, exiting to this beautiful sand beach. The sign over here, coastal, slippery, steep and rugged trail section ahead, indeed. Beautiful flowers. Oh man, this is a nice beach. That's what I walked on pretty much the whole time. Still heavy fog and it's almost like a mist is falling. I can see my shirt is already wet. There's some stream coming from there. Coming up to this beach. Today it's been all foggy, not much to see around. This beach should be very easy to walk on. Lovely. Beach is so beautiful, sand everywhere. It would be really nice if it was not foggy. Look at the sand dunes. Wide, solid to walk on. So we're walking through this sand. Beach is on the other side. Just cross that river. It's wide open space. Easy walking so far today. Lots of loose rocks to walk on after those beach sections. Big rocks walking section, you have to walk on these tiny pebbles. They're super slippery too. This is egg beach. Eggs of every size are available here. Amazing. Passing through beautiful moss covered forest. It rained a lot last night, so forest smells really nice. Fresh. So end of day four, we did about 10 kilometers. Happened to be on this beach and we really like it. And we're setting up camp here. That's my tent. Perfect spot for camping. Nice sandy beach. Perfect shallow water with the sandy bottom. I just went for a swim. So refreshing. Thank you, Lake Superior. It's amazing. Great. See you tomorrow. That's Hassan swimming in Lake Superior. This is our last night of the trip. Last night in the backcountry. Tomorrow we're heading out to the civilization, enjoying the nice sunset at some unnamed camp. Got a nice fire going. It's chilling on the beach. Beautiful. Okay, start of day five. This is our last day on the trail. We're all ready and packed up to go. It's about 10:30. Bright, sunny day, little bit hot. Yeah. Beautiful, better than yesterday. Okay, see you on the trail. So far we've been walking on this nice beach. The sand is pretty solid, so it's easy to walk on. Much easier than compared to the yesterday. Beautiful day, blue skies. That's where the Barrett River flows into Lake Superior. And we have to cross it on that log. Hopefully we can do it without getting wet. Okay, who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay. Take your time. Take your time. So left the shore and climbed up this quite steep hill. I think it's not done yet. I see it keeps going up. This is a good perspective of the entire hike so far. So started way over there. Did all of that. Came back up here. Hills in the forest, came upon this huge rocks to go over. It's quite steep. Can't imagine walking here in rain. I don't know how people do it in rain. So that's the trail marker on the tree. If you see the blue one, see how steep it is. Beautiful blue sky, blue water, nice breeze. No mosquitoes. That's some island in the background. I don't know which island it is. Very easy walking so far today, which is rare on this trail. But I don't mind easy walking after four grueling days. This is beautiful. Just came over that edge. And look, this is a crack that goes all the way I have to walk on these almost like staircase rocks to that tree over there. It's fun. Cross those staircase rocks besides the crack. It's wide open view. Beautiful day. Nice breeze, blue sky. Beauty all around. Vertical rock walls passing through. Okay, let's go. This is crack 2.0. What's that sound? Welcome to Hobbit. Okay, so we have made it to the Sinclair Cove Beach.
Is it warm?
And that's where our hike ends. The Agawa campground is still way far away, and it's 2 o'clock already. And we're pretty tired, and it's a really, really hot day. So we're calling it a hike over here. It was so nice. Beautiful hike, but it's very, very tough. Extreme challenge. So if you want to do this hike, make sure you're in a peak fitness, top shape. It will still kick your ass, but you will enjoy it. Thanks, and see you on next hike. Okay, we just finished the hike, the coastal trail on Lake Superior Provincial Park, and Hassan, let's hear from him what he thinks about the trail.
I think it's tough, but it's a good trail, it's a good challenge, and I think we beat the jungle. Overall, just have a strong mind. What the mind can do, the body can do. You'll do it.
I think the trip. I think it was a fun trail. And just make sure you bring a lot of food. This trail is not for the weak-hearted. Make sure you are physically able. And make sure you are willing to get your ass beat by the jungle. Make sure you're ready to get chewed out and spit out. And if you are ready for the following, you will be good.
Great.